Hi, welcome to Real Magic Review. My name is Steve Faulkner, and now I'm going to talk about the crazy Chinese coins by Artisan Coin, Jimmy Fan, and TCC. I'll explain all that in a minute. Before we do this, I've got to tell you, that's a bit early then, wasn't it? I record this as live, by the way, so it's not live, so don't say hello. You can say hello if you want, but I'm not going to be there. But this is recorded as live, that's why I'm doing all this. But have a look, it's seamless. Have a look at onlinemagic.co. That's my online magic course, resource, membership, live sessions every week, but 800 plus videos. This isn't just about live sessions in the community, even though there is a lovely, wonderful, warm, welcoming and helpful community. It is also about the huge amount of videos you can learn from in your own time. All the card moves you're ever going to want and more. And coins and ropes, as you can see by that, you know, still weird footage of me there. It sort of stays like that and I don't realise. But have a look at that, onlinemagic.co. Go for it. And there are, I keep forgetting to mention, there are free courses below. Free Introduction to Card Magic courses. And don't just think that's for those of you that have never picked up a deck of cards. There's some good hints and tips. Free banging, pretty much self-working tricks or beginner's tricks. And for those of you a bit more advanced, a whole course on the Spread Cull, which is, for me, the best move in card magic. Right. So I haven't got these on me. I've got them at home. And I had to come in and record the review and I left them at home, but just know that I've worked through this tutorial with the coins in hand, so I can tell you all about the difficulty of it, and that's what a lot of people are going to want to know, and the quality of this. Now, this is TCC, I love their stuff, and they've put out a series of Artisan Coin Magic. This is the only one I've got, and this, you get a lot of bang for your buck with this. And you're going to see the trailer and think, oh, there's a lot in there, but don't worry, we'll talk about that in a sec. But I'll show you the trailer now, and I will pause it and tell you what I think will be helpful, so don't get annoyed. You know, if you want to see the trailer without pausing it, go and watch it in a separate place. Well, hit the link below and there'll be a trailer there. But this is the trailer of the routine that that you get these coins for. Oh yeah, but they say by Artisan Coin and Jimmy Fan, but it is TCC that is putting this stuff out.
It's there. I
want to
feel something if it's using these or Chinese coins. But the first one we'll use later. You know, there is a very famous and obvious feature of these coins that there is a hole at the center, right? The hole. So, we will use the first coin in your hand. You see, you can move this hole from the center.
So again, with this routine, this is the first moment of it. There's a lot coming up, and I want you to understand that, yes, you can learn the whole routine from beginning to end, but the point of this is that you learn it all and you'll be able to then choose which bits to do. So you could do a really quick version of this. Some of you will recognize this kind of thing from Jay Sankey, Holy Moly, which is mentioned, I believe, in the credits. But and Rick Holcomb has some good work on this. If you want to see someone performing this, I haven't got it down enough to show it yet to make it look decent. But Rick Holcomb's got some great work on it, and he does a version of Jay Sankey's Holy Moly with it and shows you some other ideas you can do with it. So don't look at this and go, oh, this routine goes on for ages. I don't want to do that. That's not going to fit. The point is you learn it all and then you can sort of chop and change it.
I think you still remember that the hole should be at the center, right? Like this coin or this coin. This time I want you to use the other hand. Help me to hold this coin, okay? Hold it. Yeah, that is. And I will need the first coin. So there are two coins now. Both have the hole at the center, right? And we will use this one later. And this time I can even take this hole and I can put it back. You see, nothing happened, right? The hole didn't show up because it penetrated through your hand, open your hand. It jumped to the other hole.
So it's a lovely build up this, and I think it does work as a whole routine. You know, if you've got that time to sit with someone, the fact that you've move the hole is going to blow people away because it's such a lovely moment. And they're, of course, they're holding the coin in their hand. So, you know, they're going to be checking it and making sure things don't slide around. And then you've got this lovely moment of taking a hole off of a coin, leaving it completely solid and it being in their hand. I just think it's really nice. And we all know that a routine happening in someone's hand is a very, very good thing.
And now I have the last one. So see, the hole, it can move, it can jump, and sometimes it can even dance big. Or coin.
So, you know, a lot of you will know this as the karate coin. I think it was David Roth, wasn't it, that put the karate coin out, which is a great trick. So he does it in this very slow, not this routine, it's done in a very slow way, but you can also do the whole, you know, those of you know that, you know, banging your finger through the coin, which is, again, such an unexpected twist to this kind of holes moving around thing. And again, it's a great version of one of the very quick things you can do with it. What that is, by the way, is you can finish the routine with the large hole in the coin, put your finger through it, or you can finish it with this. It kind of gives you two finales. But then again, you can take those different things and do them as sort of quick, I was going to say throwaway tricks, definitely not throwaway tricks, but quick tricks. So, you know, you get the idea. I wanted to show you that because I can't demonstrate it myself. Look, but I have sat there and really enjoyed the practice process. Now, this is not for beginners. You're going to have to be handy with a coin, a set of coins, and the gimmick that you get there. It is the gimmick that a lot of people use. I'm not going to say, I don't think it really matters, but it might even say it in the thing. But you get everything you need in the set. The coins are beautiful. They're really, really lovely. I've chucked them about this. They don't seem to be wearing or kind of, you know, no paint coming off them or anything like that. The gimmick that you get is a really decent one. There is something nice about using that gimmick with coins with holes in them that it kind of makes it a little bit more impossible. And I think that, you know, this is really utilizing that fact that those Chinese coins have holes in them. They're very beautiful and you're using that part of the coin. And when you get those coins out, a lot of people will think, well, you know, that's not the sort of coin I want to use. I want to use a day-to-day coin. That's fine. So that's not for you. Myself, I've got no problem with it. I take coins like this out and people, they're novel. And people go, oh, they look interesting. And the fact is, yes, they might want to look at them, but they can. They end up with these coins in their hand and everything that you've used is out of the way. Every move has justification, but you are going to have to feel comfortable with misdirection. You're going to have to feel comfortable with some coins, and there is some learning in here. Now notice throughout this routine there is not one vanish, and this is a gimmick that is often used for vanishing a coin, and that's why I think it's really clever. I'm not saying this is the only routine that does that, but you know, this uses that gimmick in a way that is never going to be suspected, and by the time you know you get to the point where you want to get to, it's totally out of the way as well. I love that move, the move where, you know, which you're not going to know yet, but does what it needs to do, to use, as I say, the gimmick in a different way that's a lot more stealthy, and they're just not going to be able to backtrack. I think it's a really nice routine, this. I'm really looking forward to being able to do it, or parts of it. I think everybody that gets this will be happy with it. The quality of the gimmick is good quality. Now, you know, this is a $60 set. It's really good value. I think it's amazing value for money. And actually, I know for a fact they could have charged a lot more for this. I'm not affiliated. There's no affiliate link or anything here. But I was really surprised at it because I know the price of these versions of this gimmick in this set. Now, I have a version of this gimmick that cost me $1,000. Well, it didn't. The whole set cost me, you know, a lot of money. And yes, of course, there's a difference. This feels maybe a little bit more kind of brittle and a bit thinner, but I'm not handling it worried about it. It doesn't feel like it's going to fall apart. I've seen versions of this gimmick that are really rubbish and tinny and don't feel right. This really does, and you can look at it really close. And I've had the coins, and I haven't looked at what one it's on, if you see what I mean. And I can't see it. I have to kind of shake them around. So it's nicely made. This is not a cheap, tacky set of coins. This is a beautifully produced set, comes in a lovely box, lovely package. Yes, as Rick said in his review, you're gonna have to get them in position, and you might have to kind of mess around with them a little bit before you do the routine, but this being a routine that you're going to want to sit and relax with, I don't think that's a problem for me. Lots more to talk about, but the main takeaway is angles. Of course, you can't do it completely surrounded, but you can if you hold it up to your body. It's going to take some work. You're going to have to practice. It's not a beginner's trick, but it's very, very doable. If you can handle a set of coins, you're going to be able to do this, and you're going to come up with your own ideas how to incorporate this set. It's good stuff. So thanks to TCC, easy for me to say, sending it to me. Look forward to getting some more stuff if I do. And any questions, remember, I will answer them on the live shows Thursdays at 5 o'clock in the evening UK time, or maybe at a random time. So make sure you like, subscribe, hit the little bell icon so you know when I can or can't go live. And sometimes I last minute I'll just say, right, I'm going live now, so you can come and join us and ask anything you want about the products or just about anything else. All right, take care. Now please go and look at onlinemagic.co. without that, there is no channel. This channel is wonderful. I love it to bits. It's hard work, but that's what feeds it, and it's I can keep both going if you go and check out onlinemagic.co as well. It's not just a thing to support the channel, you know, it's something that existed way before this. So I'm very proud of it. Anyway, I'll stop waffling. Onlinemagic.co, share it with your friends, like and subscribe. Take care, have a good one.